How you doing out there? Are you blessed?
Are you here?
Are you free?
Are you saved?
My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I hope you're saved out there. Hallelujah. Amen.
Praise God.
Truly do. That's our heart and that's God's heart. That you would be saved, that you would give your heart to Jesus Christ. Now, if you don't know him, listen, you can get that fixed.
That's right.
All right?
We're here.
It's an easy fix.
That's right.
And it's as simple as believing in your heart in a prayer.
That's right.
All right, yes. Deanna and I will lead you through it.
Amen.
And if you'll just stick with us through this devotion, embracing God's love with
Steve and Deanna.
Yes. That's us.
Yeah.
So happy to be here with you. Thank you for all your comments, your likes, and your loves. Listen, we love all of you.
Yes, we do. We love you guys.
Stick with us.
That's right. Yeah. Hang out with us.
Hang out with us.
Listen,
this is three times a week we do this, and we do this for you.
That's right.
We actually do this for the Father, but listen, we're doing it for you as well.
That's right. Amen. Amen. That's right. Okay, so today we're going to talk about doubt and disappointment. We're going to go off of what Pastor talked about on Sunday about doubt. And we've all been through doubt. Steve have.
Yeah.
I mean, we...
You think you're going to be somewhere. We should be doing something else or something big. And then that doesn't happen.
That's right.
You know what? We've had prophecies spoken over us. And this is part of it right here.
This is one of them.
This has come to fruition. It has come to pass. And hey, hallelujah. But there's disappointment that comes. If you expect,
along the way.
Along the way. Thank you, Deanna.
Yes.
If you expect to be somewhere else at a certain point in time, you know. But it doesn't happen.
It doesn't happen.
Come on.
Maybe at that moment, I'm not going to give up hope.
Come on, Deanna.
But no. There's still hope.
Yes. Hey, thank you, God.
God still has a plan.
Yes,
not only for Steve and I, but for you too.
Each and
so
every
that's what we're that's what we're trying to tell you here is that because your life isn't going the way you think it is.
There it is.
We end up in doubt and disappointment. But what we should be saying, okay, God, we should be saying, why, God? What we should be saying is, what now, God?
Yes.
What now?
Right.
And allow God to lead. Yeah. What would you have us do, Lord? That's what we should be saying. And allow God to start to lead and guide you. But you need to be patient.
Come on, Deanna.
You need to be patient.
Yes. Hallelujah.
If God's plan that you thought for your life isn't working out, just remember this, that he has done that. He has begun a good working in each of us. And he will be faithful to work it out in all of us.
Yes, he will.
If we are willing.
Amen. Are you willing?
Are you willing to fulfill what God has called you to do?
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
Doubt and disappointment comes in many packages. Look at Job, people. I'm in the book of Job. Because I read through the Bible in a year. And so I'm in the book of Job. And I mean, he had three friends from hell. I mean, I couldn't believe they went through.
Right.
I would listen. But he had broken relationships. Financial insecurity. Come on. The list goes on.
Right.
Look,
he had a lot going on.
That's right. Jesus understood disappointment, people.
Wow.
God, wouldn't he not? Because why, Steve?
Well, listen, he traveled with his disciples. There was 12 of them. He traveled with them. One of them betrayed him, gave him up to the priests and the soldiers, gave him up. Another one denied him. Disappointment.
Disappointment.
You know, even though I want to say that even Jesus knew about that. He knew that was going to happen. But do you think he was still disappointed? Yes.
Yes.
So listen, Jesus went through it. We're going to go through it.
Not only did that, Steve, but people didn't understand Jesus.
No, they did not.
They didn't understand him. They didn't believe in him. That would be another huge disappointment.
Yes.
So disappointment is really a part of life, people. God, we're going to go through it. We're going to have those doubts. But that doesn't give us an excuse to step away from God. If anything,
you need to
press in even more and say, what now, God?
Yes.
What now? God will be faithful to you and to the plan of your life.
Yes.
He will. He'll be faithful to see you through it.
Yes.
As long as you are faithful to him and you see it to the fulfillment of what he's called you to do. Amen. Whatever it is.
That's awesome.
Yes, it is.
That is awesome.
So Diana, listen, you guys stand strong.
Yes.
It stand strong no matter what. I have a scripture for you. It's one of my favorites, and it's in John 14, 1 through 3. Do you want to?
I got it right here.
I love this. Now, hear this out, people. I want you to hear.
Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. See, he's preparing a place for you.
That's right.
And if it were not so, I would have told you, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again. Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
And receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may all be also. Also.
That's right. Listen, don't let your hearts be troubled because your life isn't what you thought it should be.
Come on, Diana.
God still is on the throne.
Yes, he is.
He's still in control. Woo! Just allow him to lead and guide you. So what? Amen. So what that it looks this way? That doesn't mean it's going to end that way.
Hey, that's
good. Did you hear me?
Amen.
All right. We love you guys. And Steve's going to sing a song, and then we're going to come back. And anybody out there that needs Jesus as your Lord and Savior, we will lead you through that prayer.
Amen. Okay. Wow. Praise God, Deanna. Thank you, Deanna, for that. And if you're out there right now, this is the time.
Yes.
This is one of my favorite time right here.
Amen.
And that is to, if you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, yes, but your heart is ready to receive. Now listen, just repeat this prayer after me and say, Father God, I come to you now. I know that I have sin in my life, but I want to change. I need Jesus to come and live on the inside of me. I need Jesus to be my Lord and Savior. I thank you, God, for what you've done for me.
Yes.
and receiving me just as I am.
Amen.
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 Amen. Just like that. A simple prayer.
Yes.
And listen, if you prayed that for the first time and you meant it,
yes.
Praise God.
Yes.
Welcome to the family.
Amen.
I ain't got to tell you, they're rejoicing in heaven.
Amen.
Listen, one more. I'm telling you, Deanna and I are always looking for the one.
That's right. Amen.
And listen, if that's you, then praise God. Listen, I want to tell you about an awesome church.
All right?
Let's go to Res Life Church, yes. St. Louis, Michigan. And I'm telling you, an awesome pastor, Pastor Rick Lopez.
Yes.
Listen, preaching. I'm telling you.
Yes.
On fire.
Yes.
I'm telling you.
Come and hear the word of God. Come and connect with people now.
Yes, like-minded.
Yes, like-minded people that will help you with your walk.
Yes.
And even if you've been in a church and you say, hey, I want to go to a different church, come check us out.
There's no shame in
that. That's right. We were there with our arms are open to welcome you.
Amen.
That's right.
So, listen, love to see you there.
Yes.
Listen, and we will see you again on Wednesday.
That's right, on Wednesday morning. And you guys have a great couple of days, okay?
Right. We love you.
We love you guys.
Peace.